Willfully put yourself in a situation like this is a little crazy.
You've got to make it just to the next day.
Oh my God.
Trying to stay positive, stay resilient.
It's always just you versus yourself.
I'm excited for the opportunity to test myself in a way that I never have before.
My heart is still thumping out of my chest.
Well, time to go.
Not really knowing where you're going, it can take a toll on you.
I'm just thinking of the possibilities of where I'll end up.
Okay.
And that's pretty scary.
All six participants have now been inserted into the wheel. They don't know when they'll rotate from one zone to the next, but the answer is in plain sight, if they can make the connection. The first night of the wheel takes place under a half moon. This celestial timekeeper dictates when the wheel turns. On ensuing nights that feature a full moon, and on nights that feature a half moon, the participants will all be extracted from their zones, their camps wiped clean, and they'll be abandoned in the next zone. The first turn of the wheel will happen under the upcoming full moon at the end of day 8.
So the shelter worked out really well. Because of the rainstorm, I got kind of behind the eight ball in making my raised platform. I really wanted to get off the ground. As a plumber, I run into different things every day. Working with what I have, make whatever I want, that's kind of my strength. That's something that I really can benefit from, I think, quite a bit.
In 2013, I was diagnosed with thyroid cancer. It was devastating. When you have a large event in your life, like thyroid cancer, it tends to define you. Life doesn't always go the way you planned.
Hi!
But we keep moving and we keep going.
I don't need my shoes.
That's fine. You can play outside without your shoes on.
My strength and determination has definitely come from my faith in the Lord. There's just no question about it. I want to take on the wheel, show the world and my four boys that there's life after cancer, that you don't have to quit. Now that I have a good shelter, I'm going to try to catch something to eat. So I made myself a quick spear. I did a lot of studying online, a lot of YouTube videos on how to make some spears and different tools.
Let's see if there's any fish. Can't see in there very well. I missed it. Get out in the middle a little bit more. And all you think about is piranhas, so I don't want to fall in. Sun reflection, I can't see anything.
And walking around with a spear seems to be a waste of energy and time. Cool. It just doesn't seem to be working.
Everything just runs away, swims away before I get close.
I'm gonna have to figure out another way to get food.
Let me tell you, this water stinks. I just want to use my bandana to filter out some of the big stuff. I know I can't drink that, so I'm gonna have to boil it, which means I gotta get a fire going.
I've been a fashion model since the age of 13.
Okay, time to boil water.
I race a lot in triathlon and in marathons. I'm one tough model for sure. My dad and even my grandfather, who recently passed, will be with me on this experience. My dad lived in Alaska, and he taught me that you can be self-reliant, be self-sufficient.
Let's give it a shot.
People's attitude towards models is that you're just a pretty face. They don't really think that you have any sort of toughness, but that's where they're wrong about me.
Come on.
I want to take on the wheel to prove that there's nothing I cannot handle. I have zero quit in me.
I'm gonna use something feminine products are great for this. Make this really fibrous, pretty much a cotton ball. There we go.
My father is ex-military, but he's also a doomsday prepper. And my grandfather was also in the military, and he's kind of passed on some different tricks. And so I think just my survival skills have just accidentally been stumbled upon watching and learning the elders in my life, for sure. I think the water's finally boiling.
Let's hope it doesn't make me sick.
All right, so this is end of day one. But it feels like I've been here forever. I'm hoping that I can get a little bit of sleep and not get eaten alive in the process. I just heard the scariest noise I've ever heard in my life. Sounds like a jaguar to me. My heart is still thumping out of my chest. My fire keeps dimming. This is not fun.
It was cold as shit last night because I slept on the ground. You're not supposed to do that when it's this cold.
I spent too long last night trying to make the perfect shelter, and I ran out of time and had to throw a temporary one together. So I'm gonna make a more simple one today.
I've been wrestling since I was 4 years old. Growing up, my goals were to be an NCAA Division I national champion, a world champion, and an Olympic champion. Life was going well, and my career was ended by a back injury. It hit rock bottom for me, because everything that you ever knew in your life was gone.
The only other challenge I've enjoyed even half as much has been the outdoors.
So I want to take on the wheel to prove to myself that lion mentality is still inside of me, to conquer and take on any obstacle that's put before me. It's just going to be the ultimate test.
That looks fantastic. I want to catch a fish for dinner, because I'm hungry.